and welcome to my channel. In the second video of Chinese traditions series, I'm going to talk about Chinese lanterns, their origin, history, use today, and finally, how can you make them at home. So stay tuned. The Chinese lanterns in Chinese are called gongden. Translated from Chinese, gong means bells and then lantern. Usually the lanterns are an oval shape, red color, and decorated with red or golden tassels. Even though this is the traditional look of the Chinese lantern, the new designs were invented and used. They are made out of materials like bamboo, steel wire, rattan, or wheat straw for the frame. Paper or silk is used for the shapes, and Chinese calligraphy, embroidery, paper cutting, and painting are used for decorations. In ancient times, lanterns served as improved lighting. The flame inside was protected by silk or paper shade, which made this design reliable during windy days, as well as this type of lighting spread out equally, not lighting only one specific place or object. Monks during the first month of the Lunar New Year used lanterns to worship the Buddha. During Eastern Han Dynasty, one of the emperors ruling at that time was a Buddhist. He ordered citizens and the inhabitants of the palace to lighten the lanterns to honor the Buddha. This was done on the 15th day of the first month of the lunar year, which became later on a tradition, now called Lantern Festival. During 10 dynasties and the following ones, the lanterns became very popular and people started making them in order to celebrate their peaceful life. During the Song Dynasty, the riddles on the lanterns became popularized. The owner of the lantern would write a riddle, and if the visitor would guess it correctly, then they would give them a small prize. Later on, the lanterns became part of decorations, and were used during weddings and different festivals and celebrations. People hang them on the both sides of their entrance to their home, which would bring them luck and keep off evil spirit. Now people hang them on New Year's Eve, 29th of December, till the end of Lantern Festival. On 15th day of Lunar First Month, the Lantern Festival itself. The activities during this festival are watching lanterns and fireworks, eating yuan xiao, watching folk dances, and guessing riddles on the lanterns. It is then to all the celebrations after the New Year. During this festival, various types of lanterns can be seen, such as gaozi lantern, shadow picture lantern, sky lanterns, and riddle lanterns, and many more. There are even war lanterns that can be seen, which are made in their own style. But the only ones that could not be copied are palace lanterns of ancient times that have their own materials, techniques, and patterns, and were created by special lantern experts that worked for the emperor. The Chinese lanterns can be seen everywhere over the world. But the endless amounts and variations of lanterns can be seen during New Year, Mid-Autumn and Lantern Festivals, especially in big cities like Shanghai or Beijing.
By taping double-sided tape to A4 paper. Connect two of the sides to form a cylinder. Take red strips and gold ribbon. Measure the amount needed and cut it off. Glue it in the middle of the red strip. Now start with stapling the red strips to the cylinder. secure them from both sides. Continue this procedure till all the space will be covered in the strips. Glue gold ribbon to yellow paper strips, the same method as we did with red strips. Use double-sided tape to another side of the strip and then tape it to the cylinder. Do the same with the wider yellow strip. Cut this strip into short vertical lines. This is an additional step. You can make a handle to the lantern and by using double-sided tape, tape it inside the cylinder. And here's your finished Chinese lantern. Hope you liked it. Thank you for watching and bye.